Hi, this is Adriana with Fact Academy. Today we're going to be looking at how to teach your dog to stop jumping on your toddler. That's a typical behavior that you'll see, especially because toddlers are exciting and they like to move around a lot and they love to play with their puppies. But when you have a big puppy like Thor, you really can't be allowing that behavior to continue because pretty soon they'll be bigger than your toddler. As a reminder, if you like this video, hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe so you can get notifications when I put a new video out. There are three main stages for teaching this. The first is we're going to teach the behavior. So what is the behavior we're looking for? I like to teach an automatic sit instead of jump. After we teach the behavior, we need to proof it so that your dog can do it even in exciting situations like a toddler jumping around or running. And then finally, we'll transfer that behavior to the toddler since that's really who we need to be able to do this behavior with. For this first part, we're going to teach the behavior of automatically sitting instead of jumping. But to start that out, this is a puppy, and so I actually need to start off with some impulse control. So this first part of the lesson, I actually call it the don't mug me part of the lesson, which is right now, he smells treats, like he knows that I've got some goodies, and his only strategy that he knows right now is to mug me. So I want to first just teach him like, hey, it pays to back off. Right? If you don't mug me, you will get access to these treats. I'm not going to use a clicker for this one, although you totally can. Instead, I'm going to use a verbal marker. Just want to make sure that he knows exactly at what point did he actually earn that treat. So when he does the correct behavior, which is any kind of backing away from my hand or pausing instead of mugging me, I'm just going to say the marker word, good, and then give him the treat. All right, so here we go. I've got a few treats in my hand. I'm going to put my fist near his face. He's licking, that's totally fine. He might even nibble my hand, also totally fine. I'm just gonna let him do that. The minute he pauses or backs away, I'm just gonna make him mark that behavior and then feed him that treat. And the first few repetitions are always gonna take the longest. When I treat him, I'm actually gonna treat him away from my hand. Good. And that sets him up to do another repetition. Go get it, it's right there. Go get it, find it. He wasn't super excited about the kibble, so I went ahead and got a higher value treat. This is just cheese. So again, I'm just gonna wait for him to pause or back away. Good. Find it. It's right there. And with puppies, like they don't totally get it first when you toss a treat, so you might actually have to help them find it. You will often find when you're doing this that your dog will seem to get a lot better and then suddenly worse. Good. That's totally normal. That's usually them just like, I think of it as them testing kind of the boundaries and figuring out like, okay, wait, does this really not work? Like right now, see, he's like suddenly trying to jump on me instead of doing what he's been doing. Good. Which is disengaging from my hand. And it's not, again, it's not them being bad. It's nothing to get upset about. It's just them, good, really trying to figure out like, what is the behavior that I'm supposed to do here? And also, what else doesn't work? Good. So I'm marking the moment his head turns away from my hands. Good. Good boy. Good. Good. Good job. Okay, so now we're at the point where he's almost not trying to mug me. Good. He's almost not trying to mug me at all, which is great. So like, when I put my hand down, sometimes he's not even licking it before he backs away. That's great, because what we want in the end is for him to not do it at all. So look for that. That's a really important stage in the training. Like right now, he's being super good. Instead of trying to jump up and get to the treats that are up here, he's just sitting and waiting patiently, even moving his face away, which is great. All right, so for this next part, I'm gonna, first of all, if he does happen to sit, I'm gonna go ahead and acknowledge that by marking it and treating it. Again, I always treat away just because that gets him ready for a next repetition. It also keeps his nose down low, which is great for puppies who like to jump. But at first, good, which he's already a little bit tired, so he might sit. At first, I'm going to go ahead and just ask him for a few repetitions of a sit. Thor, sit. Good. Also, yes, we could totally teach a sit and a wait or a sit stay. Right now, I just want that initial sit. Sit. Good. I'm marking for when his bottom touches the floor because that's the behavior that I'm trying to isolate. Sit. Good. And he's already, I think he's sitting just because he's tired. So I'm going to go ahead and move on to the next stage, which is my automatic hand signal. So in order to, what I'm going to teach our toddler to do is when she's feeling overwhelmed or like he's jumping on her too much, I want her to put her hands on her belly. Okay, that's going to be what I want him to understand means I should sit right now. All right. And we'll turn it into a game so that he can play that with the toddler. But for right now, I just need him to know that hand signal. I'm going to put my hands on my belly. Good. And just mark that sit. I only have to do a few repetitions of this. He's going to get it very quickly. He's also primed to sit. Good. Dogs are really, really weirdly good at noticing body language. So he does. Good. He may not immediately figure out that it's my hands that do that, but he will in a little bit. Good. Good. Okay, now that we have the basic behavior, it's not perfect yet, but he's got the idea. What we're going to do is start proofing the behavior. So to proof the behavior, what does that mean? It just means that he understands how to do the behavior in different scenarios. And also like when he's kind of hype or pumped, because that's a different skill set than being able to do it when we're just standing out here and nothing really much is happening. And so in order to do that, like dogs are really, really detail oriented. It's kind of their doggy superpower. He may have just learned that when Adriana is in his back porch with nothing else around us, wearing these clothes, I should sit if she puts her hands on her belly. But what I really want him to learn is that no matter what the scenario is, no matter who the person is, he should sit if he sees hands on belly. In order to do this, because our goal is that he won't jump on a toddler, I'm going to do what typical toddlers do, which is get kind of excited and run around and then ask him or expect him to stop when I do. So it's kind of like a game. I'm going to get kind of excited with him, encourage him to be, you know, like happy, not necessarily jumping on me, but happy. And then I'm going to freeze and I'm going to stand up straight, put my hands on my belly and then treat him when he sits.
What you doing? What you doing? You're so crazy. What you doing?
So I'm kind of playing. Then I'm going to freeze. Good. Now there, he actually disengaged from me for a second, which means that he just didn't know what was expected of him. Like he wasn't trying to accomplish the behavior. So if your dog completely disengages like that, you can go ahead and just like kiss to get their attention back so that they know like, oh no, we are still playing. Like this is a game. This is part of it. Here we go again.
What you doing, honey?
So I'm not going too crazy right now, especially since he's new to it, but I am moving around, using kind of higher pitch, kind of messing with him a little bit. Good. That was an accident, but I'll take it. You can totally treat accidents.
What you doing? Why are you so crazy? Look at you. Look at you.
Good.
It's on the floor.
Here we go.
Okay, let's go. Let's go. Let's play. Come on, let's play. What you doing? Let's play. Let's play.
Good.
Good job. Look at you.
Well, you got to find the treat though, buddy.
I know you know what's there. I know you know what's there. What you doing? You're so crazy. Oh my gosh, you're so crazy.
So once he kind of gets the idea, you can play a little rougher. I mean, obviously be gentle, but you know, dogs like to roughhouse. So that's totally fine.
Good. Good job. Good boy. Look at that. It's right there.
You got to use that nose, okay?
Okay, what you doing? Let's play. Let's play. Let's play. What you doing? What you doing?
Good. Good job, buddy. All right, next, we're going to go ahead and fade out those treats because think about why Thor jumps in the first place. He's not usually jumping. Well, I mean, there could definitely be food involved, right? Like if his toddler friend is holding something that she's eating, then yeah, definitely he might jump because of that. But more often, it's going to be just because he's excited or because she wants to play with him and she has a toy. We're going to use the natural motivation of access to playtime and a toy rather than a treat. So I'm going to play. And I'm going to expect him to sit before he gets a toy back.
Good. Get it.
Okay, here we go. That's what I wanted.
Oh, there you are. I knew you were a good boy. I knew you were a big tough guy, huh?
Good. And notice it's really, really similar to the running around exercise that we were doing. It's just more exciting. And we actually do still have an object that he's trying to get to. Instead of cheese, this time it's this toy. Good.
Get it. Oh, you're such a good boy. What is it? What is it? What is it? Good. Good boy. Look at you. You're so good. Look at that. You're so good at that. You're so good at that. You're so good at it. Good. Nice. Get it, get it, get it.
Once you're at the point where he's not even trying to jump on you anymore, he totally understands that in order to restart the game, he needs to sit. We are now ready to transfer that behavior to the actual toddler. So let's get the real star of the show out here. Okay, here we have a very special helper who's going to help Thor learn how to do all of these behaviors that we've been working on with someone who's Aika's size. Can you tell everyone, what is your name?
Aika.
It is Aika. Okay, nice. And Aika, how old are you? 3 years old? You're so big. Your hand on your belly.
Segura. Mm-hmm. Você só coloca no chão quando ele sentar, okay?
Let's wait. We're going to wait for him. Good. Okay, now you put it on the floor. Perfect.
Good job.
Good job. Let's do it again, okay? Put it on your belly. Mm-hmm. Turn this one just a little bit. Okay. Let's wait for him to sit. He sat down. Go ahead and give it to him. Good boy. Now you can give him the treat. Good job. Oh. Mayara, now you can just drop the leash on the floor. And we're giving him a chance to do the same thing. Okay, so Aika, let's see if he can do it. Hold it right here. Let's wait for him to sit, okay? Gotta wait. Not yet. Now, good. Now you give it to him. Good boy. Good job, Thor. Okay, Aika, now we're gonna play a game. So I'm gonna run like this with Thor. Let him chase me a little bit. And look, when I stop. When I stop, then I give him the treat if he sits down, okay? Okay, here you go. Okay, now you get to run a little bit. Let's go. Let's run this way. Good job. Okay, now stop. Go ahead and give him the treat, Aika. Good job, Thor. Okay, let's do it again. Hold it to your belly. Now run. Run this way, Aika. Run this way, Aika. Good job. Run this way a little bit. Run this way a little bit. Okay, ready? Now we're going to stop. Put your hands on your belly. Let's wait for him to sit. He did! He sat down! Good boy! So now you can give him the treat. Yeah. You can give him that little treat. Okay, now don't move. Good! Okay, give him the treat now. Good boy! Okay, now don't move. Put your hand in your belly. Give him the treat. Okay, now hold it to your belly. Good job. Hold it to your belly. Hold it to your belly. You're doing good. Don't move. Wait for him to sit. Good boy. Now give it to him. Good job. You ready? Aika, what should everyone do after they finish watching this video? They should like it, right? They should like the video. Aika knows what you should do. Listen to her, like this video, and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you to Thor and Aika for being the perfect stars. Bye. Hi, you're still here. I'm guessing if you made it this far, you liked this video. Hopefully you found it helpful. And now I have to ask for a favor. If you can, you have no idea how much I rely on your support. If you're able to spare a few bucks on Patreon and become one of my patrons and get access to some exclusive content, please do. So if you did get something from this video, please consider becoming one of my supporters on Patreon so I can continue to make videos that you love.